Welcome. In this video, we'll continue with our discussion of logic elements. In the last part, we looked at these logic gates so far, and the NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate, and then we introduced the concept of NANDs and NORs. We also introduced the concept of multi-input gates, more than gates that have more than two inputs, and we looked at the truth table of the AND and the OR. Now, sometimes we need to account for something a little different and might sound strange. So let me explain. Currently, I'm in St. Paul, but I need to get to Minneapolis. So consider a machine that indicates whether or not I'm make it to Minneapolis. So consider this. So I'm in St. Paul. I'll get to Minneapolis if I catch the bus or if I drive my car. So I have two options to getting myself to Minneapolis from St. Paul. I could either catch a bus and get to the Minneapolis campus, or I could basically drive my own car and get to the Minneapolis campus. So let's create a truth table for this, since we now know how to do truth table. So here is a truth table. A zero on bus indicates that I did not take the bus. A one on bus indicates that I took the bus. Similarly, a zero on car indicates that I did not take the car, or I did not drive the car, and a one indicates that I did drive the car. And a zero on Minneapolis means I will not make it to Minneapolis, and a one there means I made it to Minneapolis. Okay, so the first row where we have condition where bus is zero and car is zero, we have I did not take the bus and I did not take the car, so there's no way I can make it to Minneapolis. So the output truth table says a zero in Minneapolis. Second row, it says that I did not take the bus, but a one on car indicates that I did take the car, so I made it to Minneapolis. The third case, it indicates that I took the bus and I did not drive my car, but I made it to Minneapolis because I took the car. And finally, on the fourth case, where I have bus equals one and car equals one, what does that indicate? That basically indicates that I not only took the bus, but I also drove my car. Now think about that. Is that possible? Unless I drove my car into a bus, which would be bad, and I would most likely not end up in the Minneapolis campus. I might end up in the Minneapolis hospital. But if I have a one in a bus and a one in a car, that means I took the bus, I drove my car, which is not possible. There is no way those two input conditions are possible. So in this case, I should not be in Minneapolis. So here, if you look at it, this is the first three rows of that truth table look very similar to an OR gate. We were seeing a one at the output anytime one of the input was being true. The final case of the OR gate would have been a one as well, but in this particular case, because it does not make sense that I would end up safely in the Minneapolis campus if I somehow took the bus and drove the car at the same time, that logic just does not make sense. So in order to account for these kind of scenarios, we have a special type of gate called the exclusive OR gate. The exclusive OR gate has a symbol similar to the OR gate. In this case, for the exclusive OR, the Boolean expression has the plus sign, just like the OR, but a circle around it to include that it's exclusive. The exclusive OR gate, two-input exclusive OR gate, has an output of 1 whenever one of the input is a logic 1, but not both. So that's different from the case of the OR gate. Since we have an exclusive OR gate, just like we saw how we had a NAND gate that was basically a not and, or a NOR gate that was basically a not or, we also have a gate called the exclusive NOR gate, which is basically a not XOR, meaning take the exclusive OR of two inputs and send it through a not gate to produce a final output. So here is A exclusive OR B with a bar over it indicating a not. And the truth table of this is exactly opposite of the truth table of the XOR gate. So it is one when both inputs are low, and zero, or if both inputs are one. Okay. Now, where else would exclusive OR gates be practical? So let's take a walk. I'll point to a separate video where I saw this pretty actually. I recorded a video down in lab. But let's walk through this kind of scenario. We have two wall switches. So here's a room with two wall switches and that light. And that light is controlled by both those two switches. And these kind of switches are very common in homes, multi-story homes, hallway lights, where you want to be able to turn on the light from either upstairs room or a downstairs hallway, or in a room from two different locations. Okay, so I happily enter the room. It's dark right now, and you'll see this in the video later on. Both switches were down, so both the switch and this position is also down, and this is also down. I walk in the room and I turn the first switch up. So I turn this up and the light lights up. I walk across the room and I toggle this switch up. Now both switches are up and the light goes down. So remember, before I entered, the lights were off. I entered, I turn on the switch on the left-hand side of my screen. And then I walked across to the right-hand side of my screen and toggled that up as well. So both switches were up, so light went off. So this kind of gate, so this particular kind of situation, the light comes on only if both the switches are up on the same direction. I'll point you to a video where I have another recording of this actually happening in lab.